Welcome to Scientist with Beard.
Alright, this is an all new series and we will talk about some amazing people, the scientists.
Which is Julia.
And Zingy Zainab and
Softy, the most sweetest.
Alright, but every time before I start talking about these bearded scientists, let me give you a beard fact. Now, what could my beard fact be of today? Can you think of people who will be afraid of beards?
No.
Imagine if somebody has a long beard and you're afraid of him.
I know how it is afraid. Because whichever Viking is the strongest Viking, they have the most long beard.
Oh, the Vikings have long beards. And you know, the whole Dokrati tribe.
And one Rapunzel full long hair.
Oh, that's a hair. Rapunzel is a girl.
One more boy here has.
Yes, Ragnar Lothbrok has a long beard. And if you are stronger the person, like the Khal Drogos and Dokrati, your beard is longer. But imagine if some people are afraid of beard. And there is a fear.
They have their own beard then also.
It could be. But how will you have your own beard? You can at least trim it and cut it. But being afraid of beard is a name there called pogonophobia.
Why you are not afraid of beard?
No, I love my beard. That's why I started the series Science
Beard. Beard is some type of disease or what?
No. But do you remember the cartoon channel Pogo? No. Remember the word? The fear of beard is real. Some people are afraid of people with beard. So they see you with beard, they'll you know, this is a symptom. So word the word is called phobia. There are people who are afraid of spiders. You know Harry Potter was afraid of spider?
Yeah.
What's the fear of spider called? Tell me.
Phobia.
It's a phobia. What phobia? It's called arachnophobia.
Arachnophobia?
Yeah. And some people are afraid of fire. Like the hound in Games of Thrones.
I am afraid of fire. Fire?
So it is called pyrophobia. Like Sher Khan and Mowgli are afraid of fire, isn't it?
Mm.
Pyrophobia. Say it again.
Pyrophobia.
Okay, what are you afraid of? Height?
I hate robots.
Oh, so that is technophobia. But you love mobile, so it is. You don't have gadgetophobia. But fear of height, Sophia, is called acrophobia. And imagine mama is afraid of being in small lifts, isn't it? It's called fear of small spaces. Claustrophobia.
If the mirror is nobody will be afraid.
I'm just afraid of two things.
What?
One, the most dangerous thing, that being alone in the dark.
Okay. So.
And the other is with fire.
Alright, so pyrophobia. But the one who studies the beard is called then pogonologist. What's the fear?
Pogonologist.
Alright, so the scientist that we have chosen today is, since we spoke so much about the fear of beards and all, let us give a scientist who gave us some really good thing. And his name is James Clerk Maxwell. Now, he was a mathematical physicist.
There's a book. His name is Clerk.
Alright, so listen, James Maxwell, because he was a mathematical physicist, he understood the forces of electricity and magnetism.
Means?
When you grow bigger in your science, you will come across the term electromagnet.
Uh-huh.
That means when you pass current through a magnet, or when you pass electricity through an ion, it becomes a magnet.
Yeah.
So he deduced that electromagnetic waves can travel to the speed of 300 million meters. And since Maxwell knew it was the speed of light, he was establishing that light is actually an electromagnetic wave. It may look a little scientific for you, Jumpy, but understand what he's saying.
Like, telling that when the electricity passes through the iron, it becomes magnetic.
Okay.
And you know, but what they're doing in 360
something? Speed of light. So we'll talk about speed of light. Alright, and you know what? We have these electromagnet poles across.
The light goes from Earth to Sun in 8 minutes.
Okay, from Sun to Earth, because the light comes from Sun. Yes. So this man, James Maxwell, was Scottish. Sophia, he was from Scotland. And he was known for the theory of electromagnetic and kinetic theory of gases. Alright, and his beard, because our focus is beard, his beard was wild, shaggy, untamely, and people who met him thought that he has not taken shower for days. So that's how scientists would be. Scientists would love to talk and discuss, and the world has magnetic poles. So one little trivia for our little Zingy Zainab. You know Zainab, the word news, N-E-W-S, is an acronym for the four directions. Tell me the four directions.
North, South, East, West.
Never eat salty meat.
Never eat
salty meat.
Okay, so that's from scientist Jumpy Juveria. Thank you. Bye bye. Good night.